Bogotá, 24 de octubre. F. Guión. Colombia y otros 13 países firmaron este martes una declaración en Bogotá que busca desarrollar un plan de acción para proteger los delfines de río que viven en sus naciones. Especies que están en peligro y necesitan medidas para su conservación. La conservación de nuestras especies es una de las prioridades del gobierno del cambio. Por eso nos hemos unido para hacer un llamado global sobre la urgencia de tomar medidas concretas, enfocadas en la protección de los delfines de río. Seremos varios gobiernos comprometidos en este propósito, aseguró la ministra de Ambiente y Desarrollo Sostenible, Susana Muhammad, al referirse a la Declaración Global para la Conservación de Delfines de Río, firmada en la capital colombiana. Este anuncio se da en un momento crítico para todas las especies de delfines de río en el mundo. Algunas de ellas clasificadas como en peligro o en peligro crítico en la lista roja de especies amenazadas de la Unión Internacional para la Conservación de la Naturaleza. Barrera destacó el liderazgo de Colombia y la voluntad de los otros 13 países donde hay delfines de río para establecer acciones inmediatas y de largo plazo para enfrentar al peligro que tienen estas especies.
The University of Michigan football program has found itself in a sign-stealing controversy. But Deion Sanders isn't paying much mind to it. "You've still got to stop it. You've still got to stop it," he said on Tuesday to reporters. "With football, I don't give a darn if you know a sweep is coming. You've still got to stop it. You've got to stop it." Michigan was never the opponent in the game where tickets were purchased by Stalions, sources said to ESPN. Wisconsin's DNR has spent recent months zeroing in on measures to combat water contaminants dubbed forever chemicals, as well as the restructuring of its wolf population management infrastructure. Wisconsin allocates $402 million to combat PFAS. Other water pollutants. Payne was appointed by Evers in December and began leading the agency in January. The state Senate passed a Republican-backed bill last week that takes an alternative approach and requires the agency to set a specific population number. The agency is also working with state lawmakers over how to tackle PFAS pollution. The Senate last week also voted to reject four of Evers' appointments to the DNR board amid ongoing fights over the wolf hunt and PFAS pollution. But Evers quickly named replacements. A German tourist who went missing in a national park teeming with wild animals in northern Zimbabwe has been found alive and in good health, along with his rental car 3 days later. A spokesperson for the National Parks Agency said Tuesday. Tinashe Farawo with the Zimbabwe Parks and Wildlife Management Authority said Andreas Hoberg had last been seen buying a drink at the park shop in Matusadona National Park before going for a game drive around 3:30 p.m. on Saturday. Foreign tourists. Local guide killed in attack at Ugandan National Park. He failed to return by 6 p.m. when all game drives should end, and the car rental company failed to locate him on its GPS tracking system. Farawo said, "Click here to get the Fox News app. We were gravely worried. It's a white car, so we were hopeful we would find it." Kansas City Chiefs wideout Justin Ross is facing an additional charge after he was arrested Monday in connection with a domestic violence incident, police said. The report notes that the alleged crime happened related to a domestic violence incident. Chiefs receiver Justin Ross arrested on felony damage charge in Kansas. A public information officer with the Sheriff's Department told Fox News Digital Tuesday that Ross will be expected in court later that day, when he will face formal charges. The Kansas City Star reported Tuesday that Ross is now facing two misdemeanor charges of domestic battery with no priors and criminal damage to property totaling less than $1,000. The Kansas City Star also reported, citing dispatch calls, that the victim accused Ross of dragging her through the house. Ron DeSantis, in coordination with the chancellor of the state's university system, has moved to crack down on student groups in the state they say have expressed support for Hamas terrorism, which possibly involves terminating the student chapters and suspending school administrators. Governor DeSantis, our state university system and the Florida college system have condemned these attacks. Based on the national SJP's support of terrorism, in consultation with Governor DeSantis, the student chapters must be deactivated. These two student chapters may form another organization that complies with Florida state statutes and university policies. These measures could include necessary adverse employment actions and suspensions for school officials, the letter states, adding, promoting excellent educational quality while providing a safe environment for all students is paramount. Ron DeSantis of Florida is spotlighting his opposition to President Biden's humanitarian aid to Palestinians in Gaza. The United States provides humanitarian assistance through trusted partners, including UN agencies and international NGOs. On Tuesday, DeSantis reiterated, "You shouldn't be doing that," regarding the aid, knowing that Hamas rules the streets. Haley has also spotlighted her opposition to the humanitarian aid, noting how easily the assistance could fall into the hands of Hamas. While the Republican presidential contenders are mostly on the same page in criticizing the Biden administration over the humanitarian aid, they've traded blows on other aspects of the Israel-Hamas war. U.S. troops positioned in the Middle East have been attacked 13 times in the last week with a mix of one-way drones and rockets. According to Pentagon officials, Gen. Pat Ryder confirmed Tuesday that troops in Iraq had been attacked 10 times between October 17 to 24, while during the same period troops in Syria had been attacked 3 times. Pentagon officials said Monday that all the attacks on U.S. troops have Iran's fingerprints on them, though there is no evidence at this time showing the country's leaders ordered the attacks. It is unclear where the additional 5 attacks occurred, which CENTCOM has not yet reported. The same day, attacks took place at Al-Harir Air Base near Erbil and Al-Tanf garrison in Syria. Former President Trump on Tuesday blasted House Majority Leader Tom Emmer as a globalist rhino, warning that electing him Speaker of the House would be a tragic mistake. "Rhino Tom Emmer, who I do not know well, is not one of them," Trump said. "Voting for a globalist rhino like Tom Emmer would be a tragic mistake." Quote, all House Democrats and 8 House Republicans, led by Gates, voted to remove McCarthy as Speaker, a first in U.S. history. House Republicans also sought to empower Speaker pro tempore Patrick McHenry last week, but the effort also failed. John Stamos shared a story about finding his then-girlfriend Terry Copley in bed with Tony Danza in his new memoir, If You Would Have Told Me. At the time, Stamos was dumbstruck and goofy in love with Copley and described finding her in bed with Danza as his worst nightmare. John has a very different recollection of what transpired decades ago. A representative for Copley told Fox News Digital, "Click here for more entertainment news." At the time, Stamos didn't know it was Danza. "Hold me closer, Tony Danza," he wrote.